tea parties for quite some time, but I'm not used to having so many people join me. Usually it's just myself, the squirrels, Mrs. Redbird, Mr. Blue Jay, and Oates the Owl. I can't forget about him. And my sweet little friend Daisy the Deer. Oh, she is very lovely. Oh my, would you just listen to me going on and not taking a moment to properly introduce myself? Hello everyone, I'm Cinderella, your host for this enchanted party. And who might you be? What's your name? Elizabeth, nice to meet you. Oh, wonderful, and what's your name? Cable? Wow, oh my, and what's your name?
Artemis.
Artemis, oh. I'm so honored to have so many lovely guests here with me at my little tea party, but before we can enjoy our delicious cup of tea, we must first learn a little bit of tea etiquette. Etiquette? Oh my, that's a fancy word, isn't it? Does anyone here know what the word etiquette means? Does anyone?
Manners.
That's so right! Etiquette is just a fancy word for having good behavior. Beautiful. Oh, I know that I'm not going to have to worry about that with this group of loyal subjects, am I? No. I didn't think so. Wonderful. All right. Well, as I was saying, proper tea etiquette begins with how we hold our teacup. So let's all take our teacups and move them toward us, and I'll show you how to hold it. Everybody have their teacup in front of them? Okay. The first thing that we want to do is take our index finger. That's this finger right here. Can everyone join me? Miss Elizabeth, can you find your index finger? Yes, we'll take your index finger and place it into the handle of your teacup. Use your thumb on top of the handle to hold the teacup nice and steady. Then, let the bottom of the teacup rest on your third finger with the fourth and fifth fingers curving back towards your wrist like this. Excellent, everyone. Good job. Did you know that at one time, it was traditional to pour the milk into the teacup before the tea. This was done so that the oh-so-delicate teacups didn't crack. But luckily, we don't have that problem today, so we can pour the milk in after the tea. Today, we are going to use our imaginations to add some milk. So everybody close their eyes with me and imagine your milk. Have it? You have it? Okay, on the count of three, we'll pour our milk into our teacup. Ready? One, two, three, pour. Yay! Oh my, this tea is going to taste splendid. If you're like my good friends, Mrs. Redbird and Mr. Blue Jay, you prefer your tea to be a little bit sweet. Today we're going to use our imaginations again to add some sweetness. So everybody get their spoon. Not mine. Get your magical spoon. Take your spoon and get some pixie dust, I mean sugar, put it into your teacup. And stir your tea very gently. Don't let your spoon clink against the edges of the teacups. Gently swish it back and forth. Good job over there. When you're all finished stirring, you can take your spoon and put it down on the table to the right of your teacup behind the handle. Does everybody here know which side is right? Which side is left? Show me? Oh, it's okay if you don't. I still get confused from time to time on which side is which. Yeah. Oh, there's one last thing we have to remember before we try our delicious tea. When we go to take a sip of our tea, we must lower our eyes so that we can see what we're doing. That way we don't spill it.